Lower motor neurons, which are present in the spinal cord, and these have the function to send messages from brain to the different muscles of our body. So as our other body parts get damaged, even nerve cells get damaged over a period of time. So there are different types of motor neuron diseases, which includes amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. This is the commonest among all. So basically a person may experience having difficulty in walking or weakness over the muscles of legs, or there may be difficulty in swallowing, breathing. So in ALS, both upper and lower motor neurons are involved. So the person age ranging from 40 to 60 may get affected with this condition. Second type is primary lateral sclerosis, in which upper motor neurons are involved. And this may, like the person may feel weakness in arms, legs, and there may be coordination and poor balance while walking. There may be speech affectation, speech can be slurred or slow. Then third type is progressive bulbar palsy, in which the motor neurons present in the brainstem can be affected. So brainstem motor neurons are basically responsible for breathing, swallowing, chewing. So these functions can get hampered. So next type is progressive muscular atrophy, wherein the muscles of upper leg and low upper arm and the speech can be affected. So last is the spinal muscular atrophy, in which the gene like called the SMN gene, which produces the protein which is responsible for protecting our motor neurons, are affected. So there may be a weakness in overall body muscles, like the trunk muscles, leg muscles, or the arm muscles. So the individual suffering from motor neuron disease may have difficulty in their daily activities, like that is eating, dressing, grooming, or toileting. So here comes the role of an occupational therapist. Like the occupational therapist work with the client to generate the client-centered program, which will enhance their participation and task, and which will help to develop independence in them. So basically, occupational therapist will guide them regarding assistive devices, which will help them to promote independence. So assistive devices are the any design or the technique or the things modification which are given by an occupational therapist. That includes, like, there are different type of assistive devices and assistive technology. A few of them I'll be showing today. So, like, it depends on the prescription of an assistive device, depends on the client functional status and his medical condition, psychological need, and psychological need values and his routine. So, here are few of them. So we'll start with eating. So eating aspect. So here I have a individual, a lady suffering from motor neuron disease. So I'll be showing few of the assistive devices on her. In her case, she have good hand functions on her right side as compared to left. She's able to grasp built up handle spoon, built up handle knife with her right hand, which is difficult with her left hand. So this is a low cost lightweighted adaptive spoon which she is able to hold, which will help her in eating. So as we can see, she can hold this with her right hand and can take food to mouth. Yeah. So similar way, this is the adapted or built up handle fork. Again, this can be used to make her eating easier. Yeah. This is the adapted knife, which can be used to cut vegetables, fruits. Yeah. Cutting knife. हाँ. Okay. ठीक है ठीक. So if the client has a weakness which progresses over time, so we can use universal cuff. Like this is the client-centered customized made. So we can, it has an adjustable strap in it. So it is tied on the palmar aspect of the client. It has an adjustable strap which goes across the palm, and there are pockets wherein we can fit the items which we need to use. So there can be like comb can be used with the universal cuff, so it helps in combing. Like the client can support his arm and do combing. Because this she is not able to flex her fingers of this hand, so universal cuff can be used with comb, brush, even with the spoon. So brush can also be fitted here. So whichever radial activity we need to use our fingers for, that we can put it inside the pocket and that can be used. So next, moving towards for drinking, cup holding. So with her right hand she can insert her fingers inside and she can use it for drinking water or tea. And there can be leads over the cup with the straw inside to prevent slipping off and to prevent any accident. We can have leads for safer side. Then again, next, moving towards dressing. So for dressing, we can ask them to have Velcros instead of buttons, because due to muscle weakness of hand, fine motor coordination also gets affected. So Velcros can be used instead of buttons. Then there are ready-made saris available nowadays in market, which helps in easy draping. Then there can be petticoats which have Velcros attached in it. And next, moving towards bathing. So for a few examples, so like this, built-up pen can be used for writing. Yeah. There are various grippers available in market which can also be used to hold pen in a... So this is a rollator. It has wheels in it. So the person who has better fair grasp of holding, they can use this for propelling forward while walking. And the next, if the weakness progresses over a period of time, then we can ask them to use wheelchair. There are different kinds of wheelchair available. So manual wheelchair will be little cumbersome for them, as there is weakness in upper limb and lower limb as well. So we can advise them to have a motorized wheelchair which has battery operated in it. So depending on the... So depending on the hand function, there are various controlling system available. So this is a kind of a joystick which we have in this wheelchair. So the person who has weak hand muscles can uses bigger muscles to move around. So moving it forward direction, it can be moved in backward direction, sideways. Yeah, that's it. So in this way, moving outer mobility can be done in a better. This is a stair lift. Over a period of time, as weakness progresses, the person finds difficulty with ascending and descending stairs. So such kind of battery operated automatic stair lift can be used. So next, moving towards energy conservation technique. So as a person has muscle wasting over a period of time, so they may get easy fatigability. So we need to guide them regarding energy conservation techniques. Like there should be intermittent rest breaks in between the work. Tasks should be properly organized before starting it. And there can be use of larger... this is a physicist, Stefan, which is well known for his contribution to the world. He is a cosmetologist and he was diagnosed with the slowly progressing motor neuron disease at the age of 21 years. And over a period of time, his condition led to the difficulty, like he was completely paralyzed and there was no speech at all at like over a period of time. But now, a great opportunity to discuss such or sharing my knowledge with you all. And I would like to thank audience for